fall to the ground and I wake up. So I get out of bed, put on my shoes and in my head, thoughts fly back to the break of. These four walls are closing in. Look at the fix you put me in. Sing it.
Since you've been gone, since you've been gone.
The words that you said to me,
I can take the afternoon, the nighttime comes around too soon.
You don't know what you mean to me.
Your poison letter, your telegram, just goes to show you don't give a damn. Sing.
Since you've been gone, since you've been gone.
Wait for her, you know, Roxy.
Sing.
Since you've been gone, since you've been gone, I'm out of my head, can't take it. Could I be wrong?
Sing it out.
Since you've been gone, and you got the spell, so break it.
Whoa, sing.
Whoa,
whoa.
Trixie, who is the fan of the week?
Well, today, Mr. Steinman, our fan is none other than the beautiful Alex Lewis!
Give it up! Oh, get in the VIP chair, get in the chair, let her in, John, let her in. She's corned off. Well, Alex, wow, look at that mask. Where did you get that from?
Funny you say that, Steve. Get yours, everybody. Vampireswhat.com. Get it now.
Alex Lewis, everybody! Yeah. Now listen. Alex, why are you number one fan? Why are you able to sit in this chair? Tell us, because we've had some good replies to this.
Well, Steve, I'll go with three. Three reasons I'm the top fan. Number one, my car registration number is actually named after one of your characters on Vampires Rock.
Oh, which one would that be?
It might be that good, nice man in the zebra print leggings. Oh, Mr. Bosley himself. Mr. Bosley himself.
Yeah. So you've got a number plate that says Bosley?
I have got a number plate that says Bosley.
You need to be buying that, my friend. And secondly?
Second reason is my motorcycle helmet has got a custom paint job with the Vampires Rock logo on the back.
Wow. Not even Steve's has that.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm called
Hyman. And number three, the probably the craziest one.
Yes.
After flying thousands of miles and after 17 hours from Australia, my first thing I did was jump straight in the car and come see your show.
She's a fan lady! Yes! What a fabulous third show we've got lined up for you. We've got one of the greatest rock and roll stars of all time, all the way from Manchester. Who is it, Trixie? Tell me who our main featured star is of this week's show.
Did you know he was a winner on Stars in the Rise?
No, he wasn't.
Yes, a little bit like you. Oh, no, you didn't win, did you? And
kicking the teeth, ladies and gentlemen.
Rock and roll legend. Mr. Vince Hughes!
Vince Hughes!
His mouth starts to say the truth. It's about a girl that I once knew. She took my love and ran around every single guy in town.
Feeling good?
Absolutely. I feel good.
Are you ready for this?
Yes.
What a great song. Run Around Sue.
Oh, I love it.
It's a great song.
It sticks in my head.
That song, I sang that. It was the first kind of... Before your karaoke's and all that, I was in Corfu on one of my lads' holidays, and there's a guy on the guitar in the bar there, and that's the first song I remember ever singing. You know, he just kept getting me up every night. I think he could give himself a break, you know, how they do. And that song brings back so many memories. So amazing. So thank you for joining us.
Thank you for bringing me here.
I first come across Vince. Everybody's been doing lockdown videos. And I've never seen Vince perform on stage or anything like that, but he kept putting these videos up, and he made me smile. I was laughing and smiling and... and his facial expressions, which you saw when he did run around. So I love it. And then you were sat and you were going, oh, it's hot, oh, it's warm in front room here, right next to the kitchen.
And I was boiling.
I just like thought that. It were great.
I'm the fan on everything. Yeah.
I thought we need to have you on. So during lockdown, what have you been doing then?
A bit of DIY, done a little bit of casual work, you know, fitting these vape machines and these spit screens in. You know,
so you've
like
just been trying to keep busy. And doing your videos.
Yeah, well, the videos themselves, as I mentioned beforehand, I initially I didn't want to do one. And it was just a case of my head was going a bit daft with all.
It seemed all the acts, they just wanted to sing. Because that's what we do, we're singers, performers, and it seemed they just want to do it.
You need to bare your soul and express yourself and perform. And without that, that's like a junkie that needs a gig fix.
Yeah.
It's really what you need sometimes. And then
I don't know any builders who don't work and then they think, oh, I must build myself a wall in my garden. You know? Do you know what? Can you imagine? Oh, I've not had a job for a good week. I'll go and build a wall.
Yeah.
But all the entertainers, they're all out there, aren't they?
Yeah, entertaining the neighbours and annoying people. And
well, you did some in the back garden, didn't you?
On my garage, yeah.
In the garage, you could have tied it up. It was a bit of a mess. You could have weeded a bit.
I didn't care.
Brilliant, though.
I just thought, throw a couple of speakers up, put a little bit of backdrop up, and just get out there. And it was sunny. The beer was flowing.
But why 50s? Why that era? Because, I mean, you're a young man. You're in your 20s.
Thank you.
Why pick the 50s?
Well, you've got to think to yourself, when you're in act, and I recommend anyone to have a good think about what you're going to do. It's great to be able to go and perform and do the songs you want to go and do, but you have to have a target audience. And there's no good unless you've got your target audience.
Most of yours will nearly be dead. They won't be like 90.
I mean, the young'uns now, they've seen
You've
Grease.
You've got kids are into... Yeah, of course, obviously.
They've seen Grease, they've seen Dirty Dancing, that film you might have seen me in.
Yeah. What, were you the doctor in it?
Possibly. But all those films, like, they relate to. So they go, oh, that was in Dirty Dancing, one. You know, Cry to Me and Do You Love Me?
So where are you playing? Where's your main thing? You're in Manchester mainly, but do you get further afield?
All over them. Land's End to John O'Groats. I mean, Scotland. Yeah. I should have been in Scotland last weekend, down in Cornwall.
Who's your best crowd? Who's your best? You know, I like the northern guys, mate.
Yeah.
When I've ever done videos, it's always from the Midlands up to Scotland.
You
seem to get the best crowds.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not saying...
I don't know.
I'm not saying the southern crowd are not as good.
No, I can't. Wherever you go, I mean, you've got to say... And I was saying about target audience, and I thought to myself, when I was going to do this, when I'd done me old Stars in Her Eyes, I won my bit as Dion, and that would have been a very short show.
Yeah.
So I came up with the...
Two-minute show.
Well, no, he's done enough, and he's number one in the charts right now. In America for blues.
Wow.
So, and he's 80 years of age.
Tell me about Stars in Her Eyes. So, what year? 2000, was it?
Year 2000, yeah.
And who was on there? How many? What other acts was on when you did it?
Well, there was a Meatloaf one.
Was a Meatloaf on that?
Matt Shaw, Matt.
And, I know Matt.
And
good act.
Rob Cairns as T-Rex, you know, Matt Bolan.
Yeah.
God blimey. Let me think.
Who was your big competition? You won yours.
Well, to be honest, I never realised. I never took it on board as the fact that I'm here. I'm ready to win. I just thought I'll turn up and just have a laugh.
Well, watch the. You know, I did it as you know, and I was on with Jackie Cannon.
Yeah, she's fantastic.
And she obviously won the series. And
what a voice.
There's a clip of me, and I'm like this. I'm like, when they say her name, she won. I'm like. Was anybody else like that? Were you? Were they all like? Ooh, they
When I won my bit. I'm stood at the end of thinking, you know, I was actually inside the back there, you know, that big couch and they all sat down.
Yeah.
And I'm looking at the lighting going, oh, I thought, oh, these lights are really good.
Yeah.
I thought, well, mind some of these parkans and that. And then the drums going, durr, and tonight's winner, ladies and gentlemen, on Stars in Their Eyes is Dion. And I went, and I'm still looking at these lights going, oh, they're really good, these lights. And then they're going, get on, you fool, you've won. And I went, What?
When you did it in 2000, did they have two people just pulling the doors open?
Yeah.
Or were they electric back then?
Two people opening the door.
And I remember they got stuck once, and one of the acts just walked right into him, right on his noggin there. Listen, I've got a little clip of you. Shall we have a little look at you? What are you doing? Brilliant. Look at that. You look about 20 there, son. Is my story ever true? There's that face, ladies and gentlemen.
She took my love and ran. I like the jackets they've got on there. With every
single guy in the world. Give it up for Vince! Bloody crap, yeah. So, when you won Stars in the Rise, and every, you know, when we did Stars in the Rise, everybody had a real job. Everybody were working, weren't they? What were your real job?
I was a DJ. DJed.
That's not a real job.
It's a job.
It's a proper job.
I was doing corporate jobs, for weddings and all those sorts of things.
Yeah.
And on the Sundays and Thursdays.
No day job then. You were like an hairdresser.
I gave that up. I got sick of it.
But what did you do? What was your first job?
First job from school.
Yeah.
I was top paper boy in the whole of Manchester. Seriously. I got a job at the Manchester Evening News. As a copy boy, where they go, boy, copy! Like that. And you'd run it down to the comps, where it was all drop lead sort of thing. And at the age of 18...
I just envisioned you running around with your pit around the streets, with a pushbike, you know what I mean? And then where'd you go then? What do you do then?
Well, I was going to join the army at the age of 18. Got a part-time job driving a van for a printing company, a Reaper graphics company, just for 2 weeks. And saved the company from burning down because there's a lot of scropes down in the Gorton and Bellevue area. A truckload. Anyway, they said, what are you doing? I'm joining the army. They said, when are you going in? I said, 6 months, got to wait for my papers. I've already signed on the line. And they said, well, we'll give you 100 quid a week. How much is the army going to pay you? And they said, £58. So,
Is that what it was?
And then I became, eventually, after a couple of years, a rep for the printing industry. And
were you singing then, though?
I kind of sing it on and off with the bands and that.
Wow.
And I found myself that the karaoke craze took off as well. I found a little bit of a voice. So I did the karaoke's on a Wednesday night as well. And someone said, you should do something with a voice.
Were you singing a song and getting people to come up?
But I mean, I did PA work when I was DJing the Wigan Pier. I used to get the likes of Bros coming on an ad, going, ladies and gentlemen, go on, Bros! Rick Astley and the Cool Knots and Kylie Minogue, and I'd bring them on stage.
Yeah, they all did that, didn't they, with the backing tracks, didn't they, promoting themselves?
Yeah, and it was great. And I thought to myself, do you know what, I'm quite good at it myself. When I was DJing, the singer would turn up as I was DJing. I would be the first one there, last one out. The singer would turn up, do an hour, get paid three times more than I was.
Yeah.
And disappear with a girl that I was staring at all evening. And I go, and I thought, I've got to change this. I can sing better than this guy.
So what's the best gig you've done? What's the best crowd and the best thing you've
done? London Palladium, mate.
What was that in aid of? It was
after I'd done Stars in Her Eyes, I got a call from a lady called Moira Hancock.
Right.
She said, there's a big charity event and there's going to be all the celebs and all the rest of it in the world. We know that you're versed in interviewing yourself because you can't shut up.
Yeah.
So,
what we know about this, by the way, this is edited.
So I said, it's going to be at the London Palladium. Are you interested? And I went, yeah. I said, what do you want me to do? So basically what you're doing now, bring people on stage, be
the host.
Athletes, Sherry Blair.
Nice one.
Yeah. And there was loads of kids as well doing all their, from different dance schools all over the place.
Yeah.
And I'd bring them along with Kevin Kennedy. I got Kevin Kennedy when I was at Granada. I said, hey, Kevin, you know, we're doing Stars in Her Eyes. Oh, yeah. I said, do you want to do the London Palladium with me as co-host? And he went, yeah.
So I
got Kevin onto it.
Then he was your mate then?
No, really, I've not seen him for years.
And you never seen him again after that?
No, he said I talked too much.
So he was... Yeah. Let's bring Kevin on here.
Come on, Kevin.
You haven't seen him for years. So obviously London Palladium, and that's mine as well. I mean, I played London Palladium.
Yeah, brilliant.
And yet there was a programme on about it the other night. I don't think so.
Amazing.
A bit upset they didn't mention my name, but you know, I'll forgive him for that.
I think my name's on the wall in the toilets there.
So where can call this number?
You know what I mean?
happened to be a hole. There's a bit of a hole in the wall there.
Listen,
where can people find you? Where are you playing? Have you got a website? Can they buy CDs?
Yeah, of course you can. I mean,
Are the cassettes what you say? Hey, they've all still got Walkmans who come and watch him.
Yeah.
So, I mean, where can they find you? Tell us where they find you.
VinceHughes.com. You can inbox me there or email me.
And have the dates on there.
No, I don't put the dates on because at the moment we've got no dates, have we? So
yeah, you know what I mean. This lot. So how do you feel about getting back to work? When do you think you guys? You know, I mean, theatre is going to be last. So pubs, they reckon, are opening very soon.
Hopefully soon. I mean, I'd like to think, and I think it's a bit of tosh, but I'd like to think maybe my first gig might be the 5th of July. And normally, the last 16 years...
When are pubs opening? When did they say they're opening?
They said, someone said next week, but I can't see it myself.
What do you think about social distancing? I mean...
It won't work.
It can't work. How does it work? I mean, think we chatted before we came on air and you're queuing up 2 metres distance and the next minute you're rubbing shoulders in the shop.
Yeah. I mean, I was in Sainsbury's last night, you know, and I'm, you know, getting me thing from here, there and everywhere.
Yeah.
And you're getting someone reaching across, you go, excuse me, mate. You go like that, you go, all right, thanks, mate.
Yeah, I'll pass here.
Oh, do you want one? You know,
I mean, I think the slogan should be common sense, shouldn't it?
Should be. The common sense rule, and that's the old rule, isn't it? It's not so common, is it, common sense?
No.
So
not in some people.
No.
Well, listen, Vince, well, lovely to chat to you. We'll chat again shortly. Mm. We're going to cut away. I've got a little advert to go to right now. It's been amazing chatting to you. Stick around because we've got some fun. So we've got a cocktail coming up. Do you like cocktails?
Cocktails. Si, senor.
Yes. Love a cocktail. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, everybody, for Vince Hughes. Stick around. We'll see you straight after this break. See you soon. Woo! You know it's true and there's a pain. Will you raise me up? Will you help me down? Will you get me right out of this godforsaken town? Will you make it all a little less cold? Anything for love. Oh, I would do anything for love. Oh, I would do anything for love. Tea now, we're back with the one and only Vince Hughes, rock and roll superstar! Yes! We've got our incredible fan in the fan chair. Give it up for Alex. Now, if you've been following the series of Steve Starmer's Office Rockdown, you know at this point we will do the cocktail. We hope you're all joining in at home with this one. We've got a fabulous cocktail. We're going to go over to Corfu Town via live satellite link. We've got Tomo, who is on the bar at the Hotel Telesilla. Tomo is there waiting for us right now to make us the perfect cocktail. But the only problem is John's got to copy him. Now, that's going to be... That's going to be the issue. If you've been watching, we've not had a nice one yet. So can we have a nice one?
I'll try my hardest, right?
So listen, we're going right over to the Telesilla, beautiful little hotel near Goovie Marina there. If you're ever in Corfu, you must pop in and see him. Go and get a cocktail off Tomo. Are you there, Tomo? Hello, Tomo from Corfu. Are you there?
Hello, England.
Oh, hello.
Hello, Steve.
Hey, hey, what are you going to make us, Tomo?
Tonight,
yes, my friend.
I will make for you the margarita.
Oh. Margarita's yours.
Start with 45
Vince, why don't you go and join John?
Come on. Muchas gracias, señor.
Make sure he's doing it right, Vince.
25 ml of Cointreau.
Cointreau.
10 ml of sugar syrup.
10 ml?
ML.
25 ml
of lime juice.
Lime juice, John.
Yeah, everything in.
What's that?
Then good shake.
He's from Ashton, in, you know.
Perfecto,
he's
senor.
Shook his already.
John, keep up.
That's a proper margarita.
John's isn't.
All right.
Here you are, my friend. Margarita. With love, and see you next week.
See you next week, Tomo. Tell the Silla, see you next week. John.
Let's get yourself a glass. Get, already going.
Have you poured?
Ooh.
It's a short one. That's the old thing.
Put a couple of straws in there, John. I'll be the final taster on that one.
Yeah.
Vince, I would like you to tell us if it's to the standard that you're used to when you're flying around the world being a rock, rum, roll superstar.
Thank you, darling.
You're welcome, my dear.
Any good? The face says it all. Right, bring it over here. Let's have a go.
It's beautiful.
The face said it all. You know what? How much would that be? How much would you pay for that?
I don't well.
You doubt in it.
I don't think
well,
but I don't think it should have had any strawberry juice in it. I think it's.
It should be up here, shouldn't it? And full of ice.
The same as he did. I don't know why. Oh, ice. Yeah,
oh, man.
I tell you.
I don't know whether I did.
Thank God for the excellence.
Excuse me, it's Chiz office hour. I'll just get this.
Don't worry.
Steve Steinman Productions, can I... Oh, flipping heck. No, no, not again. I've told you. I can't believe he's got you ringing for him. Oh, no, Gary, just tell him. Tell him he's not coming on. This show is for people who belong on TV and should be on TV. Not when you've been on TV all your life like you and him. No, no, you're not coming on either. Don't ring me again, Gary. Gary Barlow.
I know.
Mithering, Robbie Williams, he keeps wanting to get on the show, but I need proper people on this show. I don't want them.
What they like.
Well, you know what I'm saying?
I mean,
so
yeah.
Listen, let's get back to it. You're going to sing us a song now. Now, this song shows us that... Now, when I saw you on Facebook, it showed me a boob that I can even smell it. It's even knocking me out.
Steve, can I have it, please?
Do you want a drink?
I'd love a drink.
Oh, get another straw. Get another straw in there.
I'll tell you.
Flipping it. Should be amateur on way home.
I know. Puts hairs on your feet, that, doesn't
Look
it?
Look at that.
Love it.
Get away.
So listen, margarita.
Your range in this next song is massive. It's like it's up. It's in the clouds, isn't it?
I'm told it's 3.5 octave.
And a half optics, ladies and gentlemen.
3.5 optics.
Optics.
Optics
like a drink.
Three and a half optics.
We're still behind the bar.
Yeah. 3.5. Well, that's the audience will understand 3.5 optics. They know what it means is when you've had 3 full optics drink, you're pissed out your head. You can hit them big notes.
That's what I normally do.
But that's what this song is. And it's a song called Andy Man by
Jimmy Jones was the guy that sang it, had the hit. Yeah,
yeah.
Along with Del Shannon, he had a hit as well, singing the same song.
Big song. Everybody will know it at home.
Great dancey tune for rock and rolly.
Let's do it. I want to hear you sing this because this is up there in the clouds. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the one, the only, Vince Hughes! Yes! Woohoo! Yes! Yes! Yes!
I'm the handy man. I'm not the kind of use pencils or rules. I'm the hand of love, I'm no fool. I fix broken hearts, I know that I truly care. Now hear the other than hype needs repair. Then you see me, I whisper some things and I tell all your friends. I fix broken hearts and know that I truly care. Now hear the other than hot and needs repair.
On, son.
You might say
I'll
that.
Tell you
what,
that...
me teeth are sweating.
Oh, amazing. What a good fun that is, isn't it? What a good fun song. We're slowly but surely coming to the end of our third show, ladies and gentlemen.
Steve?
Yeah.
I'm enjoying this drink, by the way.
Yeah. I can tell too much you're enjoying it.
Before we leave,
yes.
Can I ask Vince a question?
You want to answer Vince?
Yeah.
Would that be all right, Vince, because she asked you a question?
Yeah.
So, not rude.
Nothing rude.
It's not rude. So put my glasses on so I can see you. You know when you're on Stars in the Rise?
Oh, not Stars in the Rise.
You know you won it.
Yeah, my bit,
yeah. And we know I didn't.
Well, you know, I'm picking you up here. If Steve was on the same night as you...
Oh, I like where this is going.
Do you think you still would have won?
No.
Oh!
Right, moving on. It's all fun and it's all a bit of fun. We're going to say good night. God bless. It's been amazing. We've got another incredible guest next Friday. You've been watching Steve Steinman's Office Rockdown, and that's exactly what we're going to do now. I'm going to thank my guest, Vince Hughes. Give it up.
Yeah! Yeah! Thank you.
I must thank Alex in the hot chair. Give it up for Alex. Big thank you for all my guys in the room, in the office. We're going to get on it. We're going to sing out with a song. Trixie's going to do an incredible song if she can actually walk over to the microphone. John's cocktails are taking their toll. Let's see if she can knock a song out. Ladies and gentlemen, let's do some rock and roll. Yeah!
shout it out.
Everybody, hope you enjoyed the show. It's been a fabulous run. We've got an incredible duo coming, joining me next week on Friday's show. Jade Halliwell, country singer. She's amazing. You must come and join us next Friday. And Luke Thomas. We'll see you on Friday for Steve Steinman's Office Rockdown. Thank you for joining us. See you all soon. Cheers, everybody.